Hey everybody, it's Naya. Welcome back to Naya Reads and Smiles. Hello. No. Why is my camera so crooked? Ah! Make a few little adjustments. Hi guys. Okay, so today I have my October book haul. Now this book haul is relatively small, not because I don't have a ton of books to talk about, but I can't do 30 plus books in a video. That's just, my sanity will crumble. I'm so excited to talk about all the books in this haul because I feel like I'm gonna add all of these to my TBR list for fall, even though I already made that video talking about like my plans. You know, okay, you know how I said I left room for, you know, additional books to be added to like my fall reading list? Yes, these are those additional books that I was gonna add, or at least I'm deciding now to add them to that list. Before we get into the books, today's video is so kindly sponsored by my friends over at Disney Book Group, and they always reach out to me when my favorite author releases a new book, and I'm so excited. If you didn't know, book number 4 in Rick Riordan's Trials of Apollo series is out now, and it is The Tyrant's Tomb, and it is the most beautiful cover I have seen. For anyone who's new and doesn't know, Rick Riordan is the author that got me into reading the Percy Jackson series, the Heroes of Olympus series, which characters from the Heroes of Olympus series are in this series. Rick Riordan is like a god to me, no pun intended, because all his books are about Greek and Roman mythology. So as the name of the book series suggests, we're following our main character Apollo, who is a god. He's the son of Zeus. He basically does something to anger his father Zeus, and as a punishment, Zeus sends him down to New York City as a teenage boy without powers. He has to figure out how to navigate the mortal world now without his godly powers. The book is out now, and Disney Book Group was so kind to send me a hardback copy as well as like some other goodies. Also sent me a puzzle to kind of go with the book. And okay, my 12-year-old self is quaking. But they also sent me a Camp Jupiter t-shirt. For anyone who's read the Heroes of Olympus series, you know what Camp Jupiter is. It's basically like the Roman camp. There's like a Greek one, Camp Half-Blood, and then the Roman camp is Camp Jupiter. And I'm so excited because, like the synopsis said, we do get characters appearing in this book that were in the Heroes of Olympus series. That's what I love about Rick Riordan's books, is he just ties all of them together, and it's wonderful. Okay, the next book I have here was so kindly sent to me by the publicist of this author. She reached out and I was flipping out because as soon as I saw this book, okay, you guys know I love retelling stories, and one of my favorite, like favorite classic stories of all time is Alice in Wonderland. Right now, my favorite retelling of Alice in Wonderland is Splintered by H.J. Howard. Oh, I forgot the author's name, but there's a series, it's called Splintered, and it's a retelling of Alice in Wonderland. It's fantastic. Alice in Zombieland is also a really good Alice in Wonderland retelling for anyone who likes like zombie, Walking Dead, fighting, action kind of stuff. Okay, this next book is the first Alice in Wonderland retelling that I have ever seen with a black main character. So Alice is black now, and I am here for it. A Blade So Black by L.L. McKinney. This book came out last year, I believe, and she was so kind to send me a copy because the next book in this series, called A Dream So Dark, which the cover is gorgeous. I'm gonna recreate both of these at some point. A Blade So Black is the first book, and the synopsis sounds so good, you guys. So we're following our main character, and she has been having reoccurring nightmares, but unlike normal nightmares, she actually has to fight off monsters in this Wonderland place that she goes to every time she has a nightmare. So that's where the Alice in Wonderland tie-in comes in. On top of that, she's also a high school student. She has to, you know, exist in the daytime as well. One night in her nightmares, I guess there's this guy that exists in Wonderland. A little romance there, but he's kind of like a mentor and a guide or a friend that she has in Wonderland, or at least that's what I'm getting from the synopsis. Alice's handsome and mysterious mentor is poisoned. She has to find the antidote by venturing deeper into Wonderland than she's ever gone before, and she'll need to use everything she's learned in both worlds to keep from losing her head. So anyways, I am so excited about this one here. Okay, the next book I have here, I was so kindly sent by Jen from Get Underline. She wrote wrote me this little note. It's so crazy because right before she sent this to me, I saw this book on Instagram and I had saved it. I'm like, oh, I gotta pick up this one. Who Put This Song On by Morgan Parker. Again, I have been seeing this cover everywhere and I'm so excited for it. This is a contemporary book and we're following our main character who lives in a very predominantly white suburban neighborhood. Her entire life growing up, she just felt like the odd one out. She's just felt like she either wasn't black enough, too black. She's just never fit in. And the reason why it's called Who Put This Song On is because she just feels like her life is just this track that's playing over and over again. The same story, the same people. She decides that she is going to change her fate and change the song of her life and decides to do something different one day. Kind of like a coming of age story. And I'm really excited about it because just about every author, Nick Stone, who I was just talking about in my previous video, Elizabeth Acevedo, like they all blurbed it. So I'm very excited about this one. Okay, the next book that I have been patiently, this is like my most highly anticipated book out of all of these ones that came in the mail. I already know. You already know, you know. Find Me by Tahedda Moffi. This book literally came out a week ago, or not even that, I think like 5 days ago from when I'm filming this. If you guys don't know, my favorite series of all times is the Shatter Me series by Tahedda Moffi. It is my soul, my love. It is coming to an end, which I don't even want to think about. We're not gonna talk about it right now. But to bridge the gap between the fifth and the sixth book, she released this novella, which is a bind up of two smaller novellas that she released already called Shadow Me, and it's from one of my favorite characters' perspective, Kenji. And then the second novella that's in here is Reveal Me, which I haven't read yet, which is also from Kenji's perspective, and I'm just like living for all the Kenji content because he's such an underrated character, and I'm just like, yeah, I just, if she kills him, I'm gonna just, I can't recover from that, you know? Yeah, I'm so excited to read this one. Thank you so much to Penguin Random House for sending me this one. This is a brand new fantasy book. Is this a debut novel? I believe it is. So Emily Wen Zhao, it says, was born in Paris, grew up in Beijing, and attended college in New York. So this author has a very diverse cultural background, and I believe in her little note that she wrote in the beginning, she kind of takes her own experiences growing up in all these different places, and that's what she used to kind of inspire the fantasy world. So in this fantasy world, we're following our main character who is a princess who has lived pretty isolated. Like the way the synopsis sounds is like we're following our main character who kind of reminds me of Elsa, in the sense that she has this power and she's really sort of afraid of it and afraid of herself. So she sort of locks herself away. Yeah, I don't know if she has a sister who tries to get her to build a snowman, but you guys know what I mean. The main character is this very powerful princess who doesn't quite yet understand her powers. One day her father is killed and she is sort of framed and has to go on the run to find out who murdered her father in order to clear her name. She realizes that the city or her whole kingdom that she rules is a lot darker and a lot more corrupt than she thought. And by isolating herself all those years, she really sort of was ignorant to all of the darker things going on. So she ends up mating a criminal. Of course, of course. I don't know why I'm thinking of like Flynn Rider. I'm just, okay, I'm just on like a whole Disney thing now that I said Elsa. Ends up meeting a man named Ramson. And he has sinister plans. Yeah, she ends up partying up with this guy she meets, and there might be romance, we'll see. Continuing on with our little fantasy kick here. This next book came in a book box with a little bracelet. And I am so excited about this one because it's kind of another retelling as well. This cover is so cool. Like, my God, like the colors, all of it. It kind of looks like actually the Blood Air cover. Hold on. They kind of look like they could be sisters. Elsa, do you want to build a snowman? I'm sorry, I have a 4-year-old sister. She watches Frozen all the time. The next book I have here is The Guinevere Deception by Kirsten White. This book sounds so cool. Okay, so it says that Princess Guinevere has come to Camelot to wed a stranger, the charismatic King Arthur. With magic clawing at the kingdom's borders, the great wizard Merlin conjured a solution to send Guinevere to be King Arthur's wife and his protector from those who want to see the young king's idyllic city fall. Catch? Guinevere's real name name and her true identity is a secret. She's actually a changeling, a girl who has given up everything to protect Camelot. How cool does this book sound? Literally, I love the idea of like the princess going in and she's like the protector, right? Because usually it's always the other way around, and I'm so happy we get a new narrative here. So the very last book I have here is actually a poetry collection, and it was sent to me by Andrew McNeil Publishing, so thank you so much to them. Hopefully my camera is picking up the beauty of this cover. This poetry collection sounds amazing. It's called Submerge by K.Y. Robinson. Robinson brings a distinct point of view to the issues she writes about: emotional and physical longing, stigma, shame, sex and body positivity, life as a woman of color, and living with mental illness. Despite its sometimes dark subject matter, Submerge is steadfastly uplifting, full of vivid imagery and supportive messages that inspire and empower. KY, I'm so excited to read this. Okay, you guys know I've been on like a poetry kick lately. Alright, those are all the books I have to share with you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, keep reading, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye!